Right, so here is the second video of our training workshop about making these Jaguar scissors. And here we will add the labels, materials, and so on, and render. It will be fine. And let's go here. So I have write this symbol logo, and we can also type. We must type ergo slice. Ergo slice. And I have downloaded some fonts ready for that. Coconut Light, maybe. Ultra Slim. So we can try this Ultra Slim. And here we have also Loves. Let's try. Maybe. We have another Euro and another Generica. Euro, let's try Euro. Euro. Regular, regular, regular. It looks fine, but I think let's try another one. Generica, bold, regular, I think, regular, and regular. Okay, I will go for as a old one. I will go for that, and I will save as PNG and save this one also as PNG. So we'll not use black and white, but we'll use only the PNG files. So this is very simple. So amazing. So here also we can add some space such as this. Amazing. And for the materials we can use the Blender kit and search for stainless steel. And I will use maybe this one, and maybe we can search for steel. This is looks fine, and this is also, and this is looks fine. So for that we can use the gold, and I will drag and drop this one as a result of gold, but we will use this one, and both will be an gold. For is a steel. So let's build our reference. So let's build our scene first. In that we can use ref 2. And hide, select all and move to the design collection. And this may be camera collection. And let's add another plane scale and make sure the plane is here behind that. And let's scale to and unwrap the plane. and that may be surface. Yes, maybe painted wood. And for the lighting, I will add here an plane. We will not use emission or anything, but I will append some files which I have in the shell editor, and I will append this ultimate strip box, which is very fine. So we will add material and go to the shader editor, delete this one, and use our ultimate box. And I will show you what I mean now. Let's make it double Y, and if you go to here, you can see that we have this fall off and the light intensity, and this is the width. So what this node, it's make an gradient, so the color will be realistic. So this is the first, and we can duplicate here, scale maybe double X, another one here, and maybe this one will be single X, maybe here, and I will add camera here, camera to view what happens here. We would like to make a nice shot, so I will make it focal length of 100 because it like macro shot. And after that, we'll enable depth of field later, but let's see what was the lighting here. What happens here? So the problem is that we have displacement, so we have displacement and bump, so we can select all the design and move that to be here maybe. Let's see, and move in the z move such as this. What about the lighting, it's too much or no? So we want to light this area. So maybe add here an area and add to be here, add to be here. Let's see, I will make it red for now to see the effect. Okay, let's increase that again, okay. I will make it double Y. So now we have lighted it. Maybe the angle, and also that to be here. Okay, we have here the brush, and stainless steel. So we can I will go for the shader editor and make it maybe 10 or 8, and this one also will be the same. I will increase the scale maybe 15, and after that I will select these parts and make it, let's try that logo to be logo and assign. Then we can go here and add mix shader, or principal BSDF, and I will mix with an image texture. This image texture will be, what happens here, will be, it's loading, will be this logo. As image will be clip, and we can go now for the UV and scale that to be here. So let's see, it will be not perfect. Let's see, I will go to the shader editor and maybe swap this. Okay, what I want to make is you unwrap and go to here. So we must export as BNG. So we have here the logo, and I have unwrapped and mixed the logo BNG. Make sure you have the logo as BNG with transparent background, and same thing here. We will select some parts here and add another logo, but this time we'll use this one and assign. Don't forget to assign. Let's see, and rotate such as this, and you can now project from view. What happens here? Let's see. And four. So I will add loop cut here, so to define the shape, and to decrease scale. So because I have here, maybe I have here it to be 8 or 7. So that's it. I think we have much light, and I will decrease the intensity. This may be 9, and this one I will leave it, and this one may be 5. We don't want to an intense light. Okay, but this one I will increase. And that's it for now. So and this one is a stainless steel. And this one is gold. I will add here an empty and name it EM focus and go to the camera and depth of field EM focus and let's see. Seems okay, but I will say it will be point maybe point 2. And after that we are now ready to add and render. Of course you can add an HDRI. Let's add an HDRI from here and search for studio, maybe studio, and I will add this one. Maybe 2K. It's now downloading. Have out of HDRI. This one is also good. So let's decrease it maybe 0.3 or 0.5. And now we are now ready. It will be full HD sampling maybe 1000 or so, and for the performance, of course, GB Combat if you have graphic card, and performance use Tiling 256 or 58. Both of them will do fine and will save some time. So let's add and render. So here after the rendering, and of course we have here depth of field and some vertices maybe not shown correctly, but I must say the UV unraveling isn't perfect and it must be fixed. You can add UVs to UVs and can use them, but what I want to show is how you can model something like this. Layer or sensors. So the idea is simple. You can model part and after that you can mirror the other. So that's it for this lesson. I hope you like and enjoy this tutorial. See you in another workshop in Blender and using both Blender and Photoshop in our training course.